Hey, wellness warriors, are you feeling really stressed out? Maybe you're feeling overcommitted, overscheduled, and overwhelmed? Do you find that you give kind of an automatic yes to everything? Well, if that's you, no worries, you are in the right place. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you some ways to really get clear on the things that you want to be on your to-do list or want to be in your schedule and the things that you're no longer going to accept in your life. And so I've got two homework assignments for you. I promise you they are painless, but will have huge impact on being able to free up your precious time and energy. And then I'm going to share with you two questions to ask so that you never have that decision fatigue again, so you can finally know really, like, do I wanna say yes to this request or do I not? And then you can follow through with whatever your sort of gut instinct is really telling you. Hi, my name is Laura Albers. I'm the Clear Your Plate Coach. I'm a mental health therapist, a master certified wellness coach with the International Association of Wellness Professionals, or the IAWP, and I am owner of Albers Mind and Body Wellness. And so really what I want to share today is really this idea of getting crystal clear on what you do want in your life and really what you don't. And this might seem like a simple thing or an obvious thing, but so often we don't take the time to really be intentional about this. And if we have at some point maybe really been intentional about this, we often don't follow up or we often don't reevaluate. And quite frankly, right now, as I'm creating this video, we're kind of in the middle of this COVID pandemic. And honestly, there's really never been a better time to do this, to really get crystal clear about how you are spending your time, what kinds of things really weigh you down and drain your precious time and energy, and what things really light you up and really fulfill you. All right, so when we talk about freeing up your time and energy, and when we talk about self-care, and when we talk about stress management, really the key is focusing first and foremost on what to remove. Okay, so a lot of times we think like, oh, well, I should be doing this, or oh, I've got to add this in. And you know, you get a lot of advice out there telling you to do this and do that. And you know, often that advice is very good and it's very sound, but if you're already feeling really stressed out and overwhelmed and overcommitted, it's gonna be yet another thing that sits on your to-do list. And you're gonna probably feel frustrated, guilty, and disappointed that you're never getting around to it. So that ends today, right? Can we pinky promise on that? That ends today. Let's really look at getting clear on what to remove. All right, so I would love for you to get out, you know, a notebook or a journal or a piece of paper or, you know, even a Target receipt. Like, I'll take whatever you got, right? and I want you to write down some thoughts that come to mind when I ask this question. Okay, so this is homework assignment number one, which is really looking at what you are no longer going to accept in your life. Okay, so basically, what are the absolute no's in your life? It might be things that have always been absolute no's, but you just kind of want to reconfirm them. Or it might be things that you at one point had said yes to or didn't realize even that you were doing, but they are actual no's for you. So I'm gonna give you some examples that might help kind of illustrate this point. They might be things that resonate for you that you wanna add on your list, or they might be things that don't necessarily resonate, but hopefully they at least jog your memory to get you thinking about, for you personally, what are things that you no longer will accept in your life? Okay, so some examples. Might be rushing, might be procrastinating, it might be being late all the time. It might be finishing books that have lost your attention. I used to do that one all the time. And it's like, why? What is the point? I'm not getting a gold star for wasting my time and energy reading a book that I have no interest in. There's plenty of other books I can move on to. It's okay. Give yourself permission to return that book or give it to a friend or whatever who might enjoy it. Maybe it's also that you're no longer going to feel guilty when you say no to a request when you know that's really what's best. Or maybe it's you're no longer going to keep clothes that you might fit into someday, yet they've been in your closet for 5 or 10 years. Okay, and I think a lot of ladies out there probably know what I'm talking about. It's okay, release it, let it go. It weighs you down so much more than you'll ever know. You know, maybe it's that you're checking your email constantly and it's distracting and disrupting your day all the time. Okay, so be thinking about those things that you're no longer going to accept in your life or that just aren't serving you anymore, and I want you to write them down. Another ideal way to do this is write them on an index card or even a post-it note. Then you can start to post that places where you might need that reminder. Maybe it's on your computer, on your phone, on your car dashboard, on your bathroom mirror, on your refrigerator, but keep it handy so that it's something you can kind of refer back to. All right, so that's the first thing is, what are the things that you're no longer going to accept in your life? All right, the second part of this homework assignment is sort of the opposite. What are your absolute yeses? Okay, what are the things that truly light you up? What are the things that you absolutely enjoy, that are fulfilling, that create maybe some energy or passion or excitement or fulfillment in your life? Okay, so I'm going to give you another some other examples that, again, maybe they resonate for you and you want to put them on your list. If not, that's totally okay. My hope is that it just kind of sparks your creativity here. Okay, so maybe it's exercise or movement because you know how much better you feel, how much more energy, and how much it boosts your mood when you do that, when you prioritize that. Maybe it's meditation or journaling. And even if it's not every day, that's totally okay. Just knowing that doing those things from time to time can be really helpful for you can be things that you might want to put on your absolute yes list. Maybe it's being out in nature. Maybe it's getting to bed by 10 p.m. or even 9 p.m. every night so that you have enough time to get in that 8 hours of sleep. Maybe it's attending, you know, your kids' activities or, you know, their school play or their games, you know, so you don't want to miss out on those things. Maybe it's volunteer work. Maybe it's keeping a gratitude journal or listing three things that you're gracious for every day. Maybe it's prayer. Maybe it's just doing random acts of kindness. Maybe it's surrounding yourself by really positive, supportive people. So think about those things, again, that really light you up. And on your list, include things that would be on your absolute yes list. All right, so once you know more what inspires you and what depletes you, you can work on bringing, you know, more of those things that inspire you and eliminate or delegate or automate or just say no to those things that don't, those things that deplete you. And so then the question becomes, you know, how do I know when to say no, you know, if I'm used to giving an automatic yes to everything, you know, sort of without even thinking, which I'm guessing a lot of you guys can relate to. I know I have definitely been there before. So I want to give you two questions that you can ask yourself the next time that you receive a request so that hopefully you don't have to waffle back and forth so much on, you know, should I say yes? Should I not? Oh, I feel so bad. I don't know. I'm torn, you know, which really robs you and depletes you of a lot of time and energy. All right. So the first question is, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much do I truly want to do this? Okay, so if it's a 9 or a 10, like basically you're like, oh my God, this sounds amazing. I have the time and the energy for it. Like, yeah, you probably want to say yes on the spot. On the flip side, if it's a 1 to a 3, I call that the root canal factor. And essentially, it's kind of like, I would rather have a root canal than do that. And so the answer is going to be no. And I know in the next video, I'm going to be sharing specifically how to say no with confidence. So stay tuned to that. If you're thinking, yeah, I mean, I'd like to say no, but I just don't really feel confident doing that. Have no worries. I've got you covered. I'm going to cover that in the next video. All right. So the question is then on the scale of basically like 4 to like 7 or an 8, that's really where you want to stop and think. So instead of giving that immediate, yes, I can do it out of like reflex, or, you know, just no to everything, you might want to give that a little bit of thought. So you can say something simple like, oh, you know, thank you so much for thinking of me. Let me look at my schedule and let me get back to you. And you do want to make sure that you follow up. You know, don't leave them hanging, and don't leave them hanging for a long time either, because that just, again, that just drains you and them of their time and energy because they're just looking for a simple answer, right? They just want to know whether it's a yes or a no so they can move on. So if it is that 4 to 8 range and you're just not sure, it's really looking at, is this something that would light me up and maybe energize me or be enjoyable or, you know, I would like to do? And also, do I have the time and energy to do it? So you want to make sure both of those things are in play before you end up, you know, giving an answer. You know, obviously if the answer is no to either of those, the answer is no overall. Okay, so the first question again is, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much do I truly want to do this? And then the second question is, which I think is really important, is if I knew this person asking wouldn't be hurt, disappointed, or otherwise upset or offended, would I say no? And the answer to that question is going to be very, very telling because it's going to let you know, am I doing this simply out of like obligation or pressure or avoiding what I think in my head is going to be some awful like interaction with this person, which, side note, usually it's not at all as bad as we think in our head. But that's really telling. Like, it's going to tell us really what our answer truly is. And we want to spend as much time like trusting sort of our gut instinct and really looking at, do I have the time and energy and interest in doing this, instead of saying yes out of feeling pressured or out of guilt or obligation. Because when you say yes under those circumstances, I promise you it's not going to feel good for you or the other person. And over time, you're going to end up feeling overscheduled, overcommitted, stressed out, bitter, resentful, frustrated, like all of these things that really don't feel good, and it's not coming from a place of service. And so really using these two questions to really get clear on, is this something you truly want to do, and is it for the right reasons? All right, so I hope getting really clear on what your absolute no's are and what your absolute yeses are, and using that to determine what goes on your to-do list and on your schedule, as well as using the two questions that I mentioned that you can ask to hopefully avoid that decision fatigue, really, really helps you to free up your precious time and energy. And so for more self-care tips about how to free up your precious time and energy, check out my website. It's www.alberswellness.com, where I've got my free 7-day self-care challenge via email. So you can get signed up for that. And when you do get signed up for that, I actually have a free up 5 or more hours this week freebie that I'm coming out with soon. So stay tuned for that. I'm really excited about it. It's going to free up a lot of time and energy. And so if you get signed up for the self-care challenge, that's also free. You'll get automatically signed up for that as well when it gets released. So I hope you'll consider doing that. And thank you so much for watching. Please share with anyone in your life you feel like might struggle with, saying yes to everything, or might struggle with feeling stressed out and overcommitted and overwhelmed. All right, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you soon in the next video. Bye for now.